I recently showed you how to select a cell, name a sheet this cell that you had selected, and then copy a sheet to that name. So what we have here is students, and we're creating a name for each of the students, and then we are copying the mark breakdown to those students' names. So for example, if I click on the cell below here and I type Mickey Mouse, and then I click away and I click in there and then I click the add button, you have a sheet now that's hyperlinked to Mickey Mouse, and you go back here. Now, so if Mickey Mouse decided to not be in my class anymore, what I would do is I would click on Mickey Mouse and I would click on the add button, and it comes out with the message box, this sheet already exists, did you want to delete it? And so I'm going to say yes. The hyperlink is taken off of Mickey Mouse and the Mickey Mouse sheet is deleted. So let's explain how I did this with my code. So I defined some values here, sheet name to create, SH as a worksheet, N as a range, CONT as worksheet, O is a range, I response is response that you get from your message box. So sheet name to create is the active cell. Whatever cell is created, you're naming the sheet name to create. Set O range is to the active cell. Set sheet to sheets one, and that's sheet one is where I have all my marks, okay? So now let's go. So for repetition of one to the number of worksheets you have, if the sheet rep name equals the lowercase sheet name to create, then you have a message box here. And this is where my I response comes. Message box, this already exists. Do you want to delete it? And yes, no. So now, if they select yes, then you go select case, I response, and so yes, the selection hyperlink that there exists there, you delete. Application display alerts false because when you delete the sheet, it's going to ask you, do you really want to delete the sheet? And so worksheets, sheet name to create is deleted. Application display alerts true, so you're just putting the displays or the alerts on again. And then there's the other case, which is VBA no, which is to select at. Then we're going to go to the end select. And before you go to the end if, you're going to go to end E, which is a location in my script that is just before I set my O range to nothing. Okay, so then if it's not already there, then it's going to just say, we have sheets mark breakdown visible. We have it in the background. Sheets mark breakdown copy after the sheets count. So put it at the end. Active window name equals sheet name to create. So you're renaming it the name of the cell that you've created. Sheet markdown breakdown visible false. So you're hiding that sheet. You don't need to see it. Sheet activate. Now hyperlinks, you're adding the hyperlink of O range to sheet name create, and A1 go to sheet name to create, sheet name to create. So there's my set O range to nothing, so it doesn't have that always sticking there, and then you end sub. So that's how you create and delete hyperlinks. Please subscribe. My code is available. If you want to have a copy of this file, just email me directly. Thank you.